Hello everyone, Conrad here, and welcome to another video on The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild 2 rumors and possible leaks. It has been 3 months since our first video, and meanwhile the entire world has changed to be almost as bad as Hyrule in the Era of the Wild. Some of our news, rumors, and possible leak stories even tie to the impact of the global situation, and we'll get into it all, but first we have a message. To spread this video to more people, it is crucial that you like it, and if you want to see more uploads like this one, subscribe and press that shiny notification bell, and again for all notifications. And with that, let's get into rumor 1. Our first rumor or possible leak comes from a number of sources, including the Video Games Chronicle, Gematsu, and Eurogamer, who previously have all reported that there will be no June Nintendo Direct due to the current situation for Nintendo in Japan. Then again, national work from home orders and setting up high quality presentations don't go that well together. The same goes for game development, and despite avoiding delays so far, it is reasonable to assume that some games planned for 2020 by Nintendo are likely to be pushed to 2021. Now, we don't say that Breath of the Wild sequel was ever scheduled for a 2020 release, but with the reveal of Paper Mario the Origami King and the recent leaks on incoming HD Mario remasters, Super Mario 3D World Deluxe, 2020 looks like it will be the big Mario year, celebrating the 35th anniversary of Super Mario Bros. Many may have hoped for Zelda 20 in 2020, but it looks like anniversaries, especially Mario anniversaries, are more important, and that the best we Zelda fans can hope for this year are Zelda remasters and Wii U ports. 2021, on the other hand, is lining up to become the big Zelda year, as it is rumored that Breath of the Wild 2 will be Zelda's big 35th anniversary title, and alongside be the big showcase title for Nintendo Switch's top model. Sabi, one of the sources who in the past has stated that Breath of the Wild would come out in 2020, recently retracted that statement due to the worldwide situation and Nintendo's altered plan for the second half of this year. Naturally, this makes a ton of sense. The Zelda team gets more time to develop the game in these difficult times, promote it, and most importantly, possibly launch it together with the long-rumored Nintendo Switch Pro. In fact, there could be another solid reason for why the game needs more time, as our next rumor suggests that Breath of the Wild is not as far in development as some expect it to be, or needs more time due to the level of ambition given to the title. The main indication to support this rumor is that Nintendo, as late as the end of October last year, posted a tweet containing hiring calls and job listings for a scenario planner and a level designer. These are not late development positions, but rather future key members of the Zelda team who are joining in early to mid stages of the development of the game. So perhaps there was a reason why there was no release year promised this time around, but instead just a confirmation that the game is simply now in development. Naturally, that doesn't mean that the development of Breath of the Wild sequel was initiated right before the E3 2019 reveal, but rather that the team still has a rather long way to go until completion of the project in their Kyoto offices. The expectations for the sequel to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild are naturally sky high in every regard, and the elements of surprise of an entirely new world to explore will never be the same in the sequel. That is unless the Zelda team reinvents Hyrule once again. Which brings us to our third rumor slash possible leak, which ties to credible leaker, an insider, and Twitch streamer Tyler McWicker, who has a solid reputation and credibility when it comes to this stuff. He stated in late March that Link, and thus we the player, already know Hyrule from Breath of the Wild, and due to this fact, the Sheikah Towers are gone, and the open air will not become an open air again until lifting the malice that Ganondorf is likely to dump on Hyrule's 8 provinces. According to Tyler, the game will start as a linear story-driven experience and gradually open up after clearing new provinces from Ganondorf's malice, much like we cleared areas from being covered by Twilight and Twilight Princess, and Ganondorf's different plagues in the adult section of Ocarina of Time. In other words, offer a new and more bound experience to the provinces we visit, thus allowing for a more cinematic, story-driven, and filled with voice actors experience, or if you prefer, a more traditional 3D Zelda experience, much like we have seen in every Zelda game prior to Breath of the Wild. Tyler elaborated or hinted further that the provinces will have much more depth this time around, and be even more fulfilling than they were in Breath of the Wild, with likely more voiced characters, content, enemies, and most importantly, dungeons. As we all know, in pre-Breath of the Wild Zelda games, the dungeons and the bosses in these were a great highlight of a Zelda quest, but Breath of the Wild put more emphasis on the journey itself. Its sequel, however, might bring the attention back to the most crucial structures in the Zelda series, namely temples and dungeons. Naturally, if this world of malice, as HMK nicely coined it, will turn into reality, it is likely that the dungeons will also be cleared in a linear fashion, and thus gradually increase in difficulty, and possibly even embody specific dungeon items. The game will become more difficult as it opens up, but the reward in the later stages of the game will once again be a fully explorable open-air Hyrule that is likely to be very different and richer than the one we knew in Breath of the Wild. Furthermore, it seems that Tyler isn't the only source to support the notion that Breath of the Wild's sequel will feature lots of dungeons and redefined provinces, which brings us to the next rumor. As a different anonymous source, on top of confirming the above notion of a different way to explore the world, also dropped rumors that the game will have new areas to extend the original map. Though not directly credited, these rumors go in line with the hiring call for level designers and a scenario planner from last year, which does involve new dungeons, bosses, and potentially new areas. As stated, these are all rumors until confirmed, so take them with a solid grain of salt until we get a proper trailer from Nintendo. But if true, I have to say that I personally love these changes, as it will offer everything that we want, and by the end of the game and the final confrontations against Ganondorf and his supporters, we will have an even more open world than Hyrule in Breath of the Wild. Only that the boundless reward of an even better open-air Hyrule was preceded by a linear journey like no other in the Zelda series. Personally, I would love to see a story told and portrayed as emotionally as Final Fantasy VII Remake does. Oh, I can already see how hard some moments will hit us and motivate us to bring the ultimate fight to Ganondorf. Speaking of enemies and Ganondorf's potential servants, a while ago Game Over Jesse reported that a source of his had dropped information on a particular new enemy that is likely to debut in Breath of the Wild's sequel, a new type of mechanical enemy or enemy class. A way more aggressive Yiga Guardian class that will replace the likely defunct Sheikah Guardians. Imagine the terror of the piano theme all over again, but this time with multiple stages to each confrontation. A much more ferocious enemy that will stand as a major obstacle to Link and Zelda's quest to lift areas from Ganondorf's grip. An excellent inclusion that will truly give us the feeling that Ganondorf and the Yiga are striking back after rather underwhelming confrontations against Master Koga and Dark Beast Ganon in Breath of the Wild. Take joke bosses and enemies and turn them into a force to reckon with. An evil so great that we will scream in front of our screen and with determination engage them in combat. What we all need is motivation to take down Ganondorf once and for all. And in that regard, evil done 100 years ago will not suffice. We need to see true suffering and struggle in the present that we have to face and destroy. Not only destroying a Blight Ganon, but liberating entire areas from Ganondorf's occupation. I may have got a little carried away, but my point still stands. There's so much left to be done in this Hyrule. The same goes for the recent rumor of difficulty. As we all know, Breath of the Wild has one difficulty setting for the base price of $60, two if you buy the expansion pass for $20, in order to get hard mode. So for $80 you have two difficulties. Even so, according to a recent rumor, this might turn into three, or when you start the game, at least two, just as what was the case in Final Fantasy VII Remake. So how could this work? Actually, the rumor details that too, or more specifically, an assumed leaked easy mode. No, not the type of easy mode you would find in Final Fantasy VII or Super Mario Odyssey that dumbs down the game, but rather an easy mode that is the normal mode, but with items and weapons that are double as durable. This way, you might not have to avoid as many battles as we had in Breath of the Wild. Naturally, in some past Zelda games, we have been able to unlock another difficulty, namely Hard Mode, which would give us a total of 3 difficulties for Breath of the Wild 2. Easy Mode, like normal but with more durable items and weaponry, hence easier than normal. Normal Mode, same as normal mode in Breath of the Wild but with possibly slightly higher difficulty and bigger challenges. And then finally Hard, which is likely that will first be unlockable after finishing our first playthrough. Just like the hard mode in Breath of the Wild, this will be the second quest with new challenges, enemies that regenerate health if not killed quickly, and have doubled the amount of health points. Overall, being able to switch between difficulties in-game is at this point an industry standard, which we most recently saw in the Final Fantasy VII Remake, where you at any time could switch between easy and normal difficulties at any time outside of combat mode and hard mode after finishing the main quest. For a game example found on the Switch, take Witcher 3 Wild Hunt Complete Edition, where you also could switch between a number of difficulties at any time in the game to adjust the experience to your liking. And that is all we have for this time. Hopefully, before another 3 months pass, we'll have some new information from Nintendo regarding Breath of the Wild's sequel instead of these rumors and possible leaks. But if not, then we're definitely up to the task to make another one of these videos. If you enjoy what you just watched, then leave a like, and if you haven't already, subscribe, press that shiny notification bell, and again for all notifications to not miss any of our Breath of the Wild 2 videos, which we are uploading every week here on the Commonwealth Realm. Finally, a big thanks goes to all our patrons who keep our engines going now that ad revenue per view is lower than ever. If you want to support our costly productions, then head over to patreon.com/commonrealm or press the join button here on YouTube to become a member. Until the next upload, why not enjoy one of these two awesome videos?